So that's 3 sets of heavy doing.
Okay, on 100. With 5 5s and 3, my knees are just shot. So I'm going down to one plate. I'm just going to wrap it out. Two exercises down, got the squat, the close knee leg press, but I haven't eaten today and my stomach is just, I actually feel like shit. It's so hot in there because there's no air conditioning and I'm wearing this fucking top, which is absolutely stupid. I'm just absolutely sweating, I feel sick, hence why I'm in the toilet. I felt I was going to chunder outside. I don't do it over the gym floor because I'm not that kind of cunt. But yeah, we're just going to finish off with some seated hamstring curls. And then we're going to just do some calf raises because I'm just going to call it quits today easy because I still got to work today for another 8 hours and I just want to sit there feeling sick, my stomach's all cramped up. But so yeah, legs are looking good. Let's get these bad boys up. Yeah. This is top. It's top tissue. That's what it is. So we're looking, guys. Could do some work. Yeah. Alright, let's finish up the exercises and then we'll go. Thank you. So back at the gym, back from the gym, not back to the gym. I'm just saying that for you guys, so you can see. See my ugly face. So basically, I didn't eat, so I felt like shit. But I live and learn. That's kind of one thing. Like if I eat, sometimes I feel too full. I mean, if I, especially if I'm squatting or deadlifting, like the belt on my chest, just like on the chest of my stomach, it just presses like too hard. I feel like I'll throw up. Sometimes I don't eat, and then I just feel sick because I haven't eaten. And then again, I'm just like high intensity with nothing to eat. So now I just got back and I'm gonna have two Weebix bananas, and then I'm gonna put some raspberries in it. Nothing too heavy. I'm basically gonna eat that whilst I cook basically my lunch. So I'm working a 12-8 today, so I'm not gonna be able to. Yeah, I've got to eat before 12, otherwise I've got to wait till 4 o'clock and I'm going to be fucking starving. So, looking too heavy right now because I'm obviously going to have a big meal before I head off to work. So just, yeah, two of those. Then, just going to chuck on top a couple of raspberries. So this is basically what I eat most mornings. Sometimes with toast, like toast as well. A scrambled egg on toast. Yeah, nothing too exciting for breakfast really. I just prefer more high like base of fibre. Mainly because like at work, I don't want to be sat hungry at work, but obviously fibre takes the longest to break down because it's the most complex molecule. So obviously you've got like sugar, which is like the easiest, then it goes to like carbs, protein, and then your fiber. So obviously you want, you know, if you're trying to cut down or like try and limit your snacking, up your fiber and a lot of milk. I do like it kind of like drenched in milk, but obviously this is a green milk, so it's like 50-50 good and protein. Alright, so let's back out again. So I feel like I've kind of hit a wall with my squats, to be fair. I've been squatting comfortably 100 kilos for about too fucking long, basically. I can squat obviously 120, I can hit a 140, but I just kind of seem to have plateaued a little bit. What I need to do is just, I don't know really. But I've tried to change my diet, tried to change the order I do legs in, tried to focus more on like close together to, you know, strengthen the widening area. I think I need more hamstring focus, to be fair. Sounds a bit weird with squat, you know, you think it'd be quad focused, but I can take the weight down, it's just then pressing back up, it's that stop, that 90 degree stop and then press back up. I don't like to bomb the weight, which obviously engages more glutes and hamstrings, I think. So, but yeah, no, it's a weird one really. I feel stronger, my legs are getting bigger. Everything else is going up. Just can't seem to get my squat up, although my legs are improving. It's just one of those things. I don't know if it's mental, or just because I failed so many like reps. Just psyching myself out, or I'm not pushing through. I don't know what it is, but no, I'm still improving. What are you gonna do, eh? Alright, so we're gonna cook some lunch. So basically, I'm gonna get a chicken breast, I'm gonna slice it in half, cover both sides. I don't like a thick chicken breast, I'm just gonna lightly slice it and then quickly fry it so it's got a little bit of colour to it. Then we're gonna do some veggies, so I'm just gonna do a pepper and then whack on the rice. So obviously, we're gonna have protein, carbs, and fibre. Obviously,
you know, most meals you want. Obviously, you still need high, like high protein and high fibre, and obviously you do need to maintain carbs, otherwise you're just gonna feel like shit. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do. Just gonna quickly go through that, and I'll show you guys through this. That's what I do basically. So just grab a bag of chicken basically. Put that on there. Put that there for a second. Fuck. Yeah, and then basically what we're gonna do is just hold it down. You gotta slide it in. And then with a knife, roll it basically. You don't want to be sawing it, and then get it open like so, and then just long strokes to open up the chicken like so. Yeah. Voila! So your chicken is just diced into two pieces, right? Get rid of all this shit. Get your pan ready, which is so I use a light, fry light, just because healthier, and I don't really see a difference between that. You just do a couple more sprays than normally, and you have the same effect as normal cooking oil, which obviously is absolutely fine. Then we've got our then we're taking some chili and garlic salt, which is like pink Himalayan salt. Just gonna put some of that into the pan already. Do my chicken. So that's just, I find, a lot better than using your original salt and pepper. Obviously, don't want all that salt really. Obviously you need salt in your diet. I'm not saying you need to cut out all your salt, just for flavouring as well. Yeah. So because we put the salt underneath, basically you don't really need to like flip it straight away and then get the other side, because obviously it's got a bit of colour on it, so that's not going to stick. So you're basically just going to have one side, it's going to have loads of flavour, and then the other side is just going to basically have like fucking nothing. So no, just put it in your pan, pre-prep it. That's going to sit in there for about 2.5 minutes. And then we're good. But I'm just going to put some more around the pan. Just a quick sprinkle. In the pan, basically. And then we're done. Forgot about my breakfast. Some chili in it. So just cut around your pepper. So basically, you got a core there. don't bother about getting all the seeds out and shit. Strip it. Just put into strips. Nothing really too exciting. So you see right now, I've got that.
That was already diced. Chicken, look at that. Smells amazing. I've only got my porridge, which I like it a bit wet. So I just let it soak for a bit. And then just a little bit mushy, but that's just going to be really nice. And then I'm going to have a coffee with my amazing tatami. Because I can. Alright, just going to whack some rice with it. And then I'm just going to show you, yeah, basically plate it up and then see what we're doing. I like how I can reflect it in this. That's me. Alright, guys, so basically, I'm gonna see you in the next one. Tomorrow, I'm gonna do a chest workout, so probably film that. Out of everything, my chest has obviously improved the most. I find actually really starting to get intense on the bench press, moving from more of the incline and more to just like the flat bench has really helped me create, you know. Kind of a definition, more like structure, especially around all the shoulders here. So on the sides, really starting to bring it out instead of creating more definition of the chest. So I'll show you that, guys. Like, subscribe, comment, all that good shit, and I'll show you how it's just on the face up. Alright, peace. So final move for the day, got egg fried rice we made. So it's got 4 eggs in there, rice, peas and spring onions. And then we just got some sweet and sour chicken from Uncle Ben's on the top. So yeah, just again, some high protein and carbs. We dish it up.